Greetings. This video refutes argument number 7 from the silly flood list sent by a follower of Muhammad. Let's look at the claim. According to the Word of God, the Bible, Jesus didn't say, "Worship me." Instead, when a woman asked Jesus, "Whom must I worship?" then Jesus told her, "Worship God the Father." John 4:21. Surprisingly enough, Jesus himself used to worship God the Father. Matthew 26:36. So Jesus is not God. So the point of this claim is that Jesus is not God based on 3 facts. Jesus never said, "Worship me." Jesus answered, "Worship God the Father," when asked. And Jesus used to worship God the Father. Let's examine fact 1. Jesus never said, "Worship me." Technically, this is true. Jesus never said the words, "Worship me." But stopping there is critically flawed thinking. Because Jesus received worship, and Jesus never refused worship when it was given to him. Here's one example, Matthew 28:9. This is after Jesus' crucifixion and his resurrection. And as they went to tell his disciples, behold, Jesus met them, saying, "All hail." And they came and held him by the feet and worshipped him. They held him by the feet. They were bowing prostrate to Jesus, just as Mohammedans are taught to bow low to their Allah. These men worshipped Jesus. So point 1 of this claim is clearly wrong. Jesus accepted worship. And think clearly for a moment. If Jesus did say, "Worship me," would that statement make him God? No, it would not. And if the Bible did record Jesus said, "Worship me," would someone obeying Muhammad respect it? No, they would not. Do they respect Jesus' own words that he is the Son of God? No, they do not. So again, fact 1 of the claim is flawed. Jesus accepted worship. Fact 2. Jesus answered, "Worship God the Father," when asked. The verse cited is John 4:21. Let's look at John 4:21 in context. The story begins in John 4:4 with Jesus traveling to a city of Samaria, stopping at a well, talking with a woman there, and asking for a drink. "There cometh a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus saith unto her, Give me to drink. For his disciples were gone away unto the city to buy meat. Then saith the woman of Samaria unto him, How is it that you, being a Jew, ask drink of me, which am a woman of Samaria? For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans." Jesus answered and said unto her, "If thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that saith unto thee, Give me to drink, thou wouldst have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water." Notice, Jesus is talking about himself here. "Thou wouldst have asked of him, and he would have given you living water." Jesus gives the water of life as he wills to those who ask. Jesus does not say, "If Allah wills." The woman saith unto him, "Sir, thou hast nothing to draw with, and the well is deep." You see, she thinks he's talking about water from this well. "From whence, then, hast thou that living water? Art thou greater than our father Jacob, which gave us the well and drank thereof himself and his children and his cattle?" Jesus answered and said unto her, "Whosoever drinketh of this water shall thirst again." Here Jesus is talking about the well that they're sitting at, and if you drink the physical water of the well, you will get thirsty. "But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give him shall never thirst." But the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life. The woman saith unto him, Sir, give me this water, that I thirst not, neither come here to draw. Now Jesus appears to change the subject. Jesus saith unto her, Go, call thy husband, and come hither. The woman answered and said, I have no husband. Jesus saith unto her, Thou hast well said, I have no husband. For thou hast had five husbands, and he whom thou now hast is not thy husband. In that said you truly. The woman saith unto him, Sir, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Jesus tells her things that no stranger could know. So she rightly concludes, Jesus is a prophet. What does she say next? Our fathers worshipped in this mountain, and you say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Notice John 4:20. And you say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Worship in Jerusalem. Worship in Jerusalem, not Mecca. And now we finally come to the verse the Mohammedan twists. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, believe me, the hour comes when you shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. Notice, the woman did not ask Jesus about who to worship. So fact two is another false statement, another lie from Islam. Fact two claims Jesus answered, Worship God the Father, when asked. The first problem for Islam here is the woman does not ask who to worship. This is another Islamic lie. The second problem for Islam here is that Jesus calls God the Father. Islam simply hates this truth. The third problem here is that Jesus is describing a change in worship practice. He is not saying who to worship. The fourth problem for Islam is that it has no idea what Jesus taught, to worship God in spirit and in truth, because Islam does not respect truth. Fact one and fact two are crushed. Fact three is just as bogus. The verse cited does not mention worship. It mentions prayer. But John 4 is so rich in truths that it is hard to limit this to refuting such a laughable claim. So let's keep reading. You worship you know not what. We know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, and now is, and now is. Think about what those words mean in context. The hour comes, and now is. Right now. Right now. Jesus is talking about right now. When the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him. If you want to be Muslim, if to you the word Muslim means you submit honestly to God, you have to submit to God in spirit and in truth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will give you living water, welling up to eternal life, if only you will ask Him. Amen.